The war in Ukraine and its impact on your personal finances. Coming up. Hi everyone, this is Dr. Ernesto from Attaboy Cowboy, and on this channel we give you health and wealth tips to help you be more successful. Now today I'm in Joshua Tree National Park. I just love this place. It just has the best vibe. I feel like it's an energy vortex. It really refreshes me when I come here. And all these cool trees around me, you see, these are the world famous Joshua trees, the ones that Bono sings about in the U2 song. But anyway, let's talk about what's happening in Ukraine. So let's go over three important points to consider. First, let's talk about the war and what exactly is going on. So Russia is invading the Ukraine, which makes no sense. I really don't know why. Most people don't really know why he's doing it. Some people think that he has dementia or some other type of psychiatric disorder, but who knows? But the impact is that the United States and Europe and the United Kingdom are unleashing weapons of mass economic destruction. I've actually never seen anything like this. They're really hitting them hard economically. And I really think they're doing it not only to try to calm them down so they'll pull out, but also to kind of warn China, like, hey, if you try to invade Taiwan, this is what's going to happen. This is actually unprecedented. Every country is getting together and they're really sanctioning, which is another word for saying penalizing, Russia. So big companies like Nike, IKEA, DHL, Apple, all the big companies have left or are in the process of leaving Russia. So they're not manufacturing, they're not selling, nothing. They're being blocked from pretty much everything. They can't, if you have an iPhone and you live in Russia, you're not going to be able to get the latest software updates. They're blocking all technological updates, software, everything's being blocked from the United States, China, and Europe. If you want to have a modern economy, you pretty much cannot unless you have stuff that's coming from those three places, because they produce a lot of the major economic components that people use. They make power plants, planes, aviation, like just software, everything, just satellites, everything you think of, the high-end comes from those countries. So if you can't get that, you're going to go back to the Stone Ages. And another thing they're doing is they're blocking their planes. So Aeroflot, which is their national airline, can no longer fly to the United States, to Europe, to a lot of places. So they're trapped. So rich people in Europe are not able to go anywhere. They're stuck. Business people are not able to leave the country to do business. And other countries are actually going in and seizing economic assets that belong to oligarchs. Oligarchs is another word for like Putin's buddies that basically when the USSR collapsed, they divided up everything and said, okay, you're going to get tin, my judo partner is going to get the oil wells, you're going to get the coal well, you know, coal mines, etc. And they just divide everything up and they're just taking all their stuff, their luxury apartments, their condos, their mansions. I think in Germany, I just read they impounded a $700 million yacht that had the largest pool anywhere in the world on a boat. It's almost the size of a football field. In France, they did the same to another yacht. They're just, it's kind of cool. They're trying to bully Putin. They're taking all these things from his buddies so that his buddies will say, hey, dude, what are you doing? Why don't you pull out? They're taking all their stuff. All these people are being blacklisted. All the banks are being blacklisted. It's just crazy what they're doing to them. It's good. It's a good thing to stop the war, but I think it's going to have a significant impact. Just think about what happened when they took Crimea, which is a really small portion of Ukraine in 2014, it decreased their economy by 40% just because of the sanctions and at that time. On a scale of 1 to 10, the sanctions they put on Russia in 2014 were about a 6. And it shrank their economy down smaller than Italy's and Mexico's, just to give you an idea. Their economy is not very big. It's about 1.7 trillion a year. In comparison, the United States is about 22 trillion a year. So if you think about it, it's not even 10%. It's nothing. It's like 7%. But they punch above the belt. They have like a lot of clout because they have the largest nuclear stockpile in the world and they're one of the top three oil explorers in the world, along with Saudi Arabia and the United States. Luckily, we no longer really depend on them or anybody for oil. We're a net oil exporter now. But it does influence the world markets. And that's why we're seeing here in the United States, in California anyway, we're at almost $6 gasoline now, which is crazy. It was $3 just a few weeks ago before the war. But that's the price of war, ends up costing everybody. And an interesting thing the United States is doing in Europe is they're no longer trying to take away assets, which takes a long time. They have to fight in court. It's tricky. Now they've kind of wised up. They just freeze assets. So Russia has money all around the world in banks. It's all frozen. And they could stay frozen for years or indefinitely. And the cool thing about that is when they try to fight for it in court, that can take years. It takes a lot of time. Sometimes the other country can pull their money out in the meantime. But when they just freeze everything, it's done. You can't do anything with the money. So Russia has lost access to all this money all over the world. Putin tried to build an economic fortress. He stockpiled foreign reserves, and he thought he was going to be able to survive this war by just selling oil and getting more dollars and euros in exchange for it and using it to buy goods and services that Russia still needs, because he knew that they were going to get cut off from foreign reserve markets. But he did not know that they were going to go to these steps that are going, blocking off technology, blocking off their airspace, just doing everything, blocking off transactions with banks. They sanctioned all their top banks, so they're not able to do trades with other banks in other countries. So that's just a killer. It's going to probably drive their economy down to complete collapse, and it's probably going to take decades to recover. Again, I don't think this has ever happened, so it's going to just ruin their economy for a piece of land that they really don't need, because Russia is already the largest country in the world by landmass, and there really isn't anything in Ukraine that they need. They have all the oil and gas they need. They basically just send pipelines through there, but they don't need those either, because they just made one of the largest pipelines in the world, the Nord Stream 2, that goes directly to Germany, which is one of their largest customers. So it just makes no sense. Point number two, inflation. All right, so let's talk about something really cool I learned about. It's called the money illusion. So right now, everywhere, you're seeing pay raises. I was driving down the street now, and I saw signs at McDonald's saying $18 an hour, where normally they might pay like, I don't know, $13, $14 an hour here. Everybody's raising their wages. Everybody thinks they're making more money. Those are called nominal wages, like the number. The number's going up from 14 to 18. But real wages are actually going down because inflation's going up. Our average inflation in the United States is around 2%, and right now it's about 7.5%. This is before the war. So we're at a 40-year high. Just wait till the stuff from the war comes in. It's just gonna be like a bomb. This is gonna be the second wave of this inflation. It's gonna be the worst probably since the 80s. And I'm already reading about some economists saying that they're worried we might go into an 80s style stagflation or massive amounts of interest rates. I mean, it can just be really bad, but we'll see how long this war drags on. All right, let me explain what that means. In nominal wages, you get $100, but your real wages, when you subtract inflation of 7.5, is $92.50. So you basically have to subtract 7.5% from everything. So if you got a 3% pay raise, you actually lost 4.5%. That's the way you have to look at it. On the flip side, if you're getting long-term loans, like mortgage loans, it's a really good time. Because if you're getting like a 4% loan, but inflation's 7.5%, you actually have a negative 3.5% interest on your loan. So if you have $100 you borrowed, at the end of the year, it's as if you had $103.50. You're making money. The bank is absorbing all the losses. So if you can, take as many of these long-term loans as you can. So in actuality, real wages in the United States are only going up around 1% on average. That's it. Even though someone might say, hey, I got a 5% pay raise or a 6% or whatever, you're losing money if it's anything less than a 7.5% pay raise. So on average, I think people are getting around 8.5%, so they're coming out with 1%. But when they look at their check, they see a larger number, they think they have more money, they want to go out and spend. But then when you go to the market, you're like, whoa, I just went to the market yesterday. I spent $150 on 2 small bags of groceries for the week. So that's a lot. I usually spend about, I don't know, 50, 60 bucks. My food bill's about tripled. Now, another factor to keep in mind is interest rates. The Federal Reserve sees all this inflation coming. The way to control inflation is with interest rates, what they call monetary policy. So if you have low interest rates, like when we had mortgage rates at 3%, everyone and their mother went out and bought a house. That made the house prices skyrocket. They create a lot of demand because it's cheap money. And people are like, wow, we want this cheap money. Like I just said, if you can get a 3% interest rate loan and inflation is 7.5%, you're gonna net 4.5%. You're gonna make 4.5% on that loan. So what they do is they raise interest rates to make money more expensive. So people will buy less houses, buy less cars, buy less of everything. That helps control inflation and lower it down. That's what happened in the 80s. We had double digit inflation. We had double digit interest rates, and it just killed economic activity and it forced us into a recession. Unfortunately, that's what's coming up. We're gonna be forced into a recession because of the high interest rates that we're expecting this year. From the Federal Reserve raising interest rates. And 3, you wanna consider the economic impact. How is this gonna affect you personally? Okay, first off, oil prices are gonna skyrocket. This is just the beginning. We'll probably see $10 gas in the United States, which I've never seen. It's close to $6 now. The war just started. So it's gonna get nasty with oil. And remember, oil is the basis of all inputs in the world. So pretty much everything has some portion of oil involved in it. Whether you're growing apples or you're making sweaters, you're gonna need oil. So it's gonna cause a lot more inflation. We're gonna have hyperinflation around the world. My advice, if you need to buy something like a laptop or a car or any kind of major purchase, this is the time to do it because it's only gonna get worse. Another thing is that in Russia, not only do they export a lot of oil, they're one of the largest metal exporters in the world. They produce metals for all sorts of stuff, tin, tungsten, cadmium, whatever, all sorts of stuff. In fact, catalytic converters, the metal that goes into it, 46% of that metal comes from Russia. So that's gonna make car prices go way up. If you need to buy a car, I know they're high already because of the shortage of microchips. It's gonna get worse now because of the metal shortages we're gonna have. So you wanna make all your large purchases. And if you have money in the bank, you need to spend it. You wanna invest it in land or real estate or something else that goes up in times of real inflation. Okay, so you're gonna have decreased purchasing power overall because your money is gonna devalue, inflation is gonna go way high, we're gonna have more shortages of stuff, we're gonna have oil going up high. So everything's about to get really expensive. So if you wanna take a trip, do it now. You wanna buy something big, like I said, a car, computer, anything like that, buy it now. Otherwise, if you have cash sitting in the bank, get rid of it. Pay off some bills, buy some land. That's probably the best thing you do. Buy some real estate. Buy things that are inflation protected. If you want some options on what to buy, look at the video I made on investments to buy in times of high inflation. But all in all, this Ukraine war is gonna have an outsized economic impact worldwide because of Russia's impact on the oil market and the importance of oil on everyone. Oil was already going up right before this happened. It reached almost $100 a barrel. Now it's gonna go up to, who knows, maybe $200 a barrel. So it's gonna push us into a recession, maybe even a depression. The interesting thing is that this is kind of what happened when the Spanish flu happened. This is happening right on the heels of COVID. So history seems to be repeating itself. So from Joshua Tree National Park, this is Dr. Ernesto Martinez. If you have any questions, please comment below. And if you haven't already, please subscribe to our channel. Thank you and goodbye.